When it comes to emergency communications, it has to be solid, reliable, and scalable. In ham radio, we often use AREDN networks for that purpose. Because they run on 2.4 or 5.8 GHz, their performance is high and allows to build mesh networks for flexibility and reliability. Today, we will add the next level, redundant voice over IP. Be with me when one of my dreams comes true. Hello, wireless enthusiasts. Here is the channel with a strange Swiss distortion in the signal with a new video around wireless and other exciting stuff. Make sure you subscribe if you do not want to miss the following emissions. AREDN is a TCP/IP based mesh. Remember, the TCP/IP protocol was developed in the 1970s as a reliable network for the military. So we can trust this level of communication. However, the next level is more complex because we often use products or concepts invented for standard scenarios. Today we will look at voice over IP telephony. Later we might also look at mail or chat. Most of us use standard telephones like this one from Yealink, Cisco or Grandstream. They were used in offices and now are replaced by Microsoft Teams. This is why we get them very cheap. These phones are made for networks with private branch exchanges, short PBXs. In this setup, all telephones are connected to a common PBX and all calls go via this PBX. It also has a phone book and knows how to reach all subscribers. If the opposite station is further away, the PBXs connect for this call. If a PBX is down, all telephones are down too. Compare this setup with a mesh. It is the pure contrary. The meshes are made of small connected routers with one or more telephones. So we have no single point of failure. We only lose this part if a router or a phone quits operation. The rest continues operating. Using a PBX immediately destroys this feature. Unfortunately, this is not all. If traffic is routed through the PBX, the line from and to the PBX gets the full load of all telephone calls. In addition, each link adds delay. Too much delay is the death of voice over IP. A single point of failure, capacity bottlenecks, and severe restrictions because of unnecessary delays. I never liked this idea. This is why I started dreaming when Tim, DL4FLY, told me that they use direct calling. Voice over IP phones can call any other phone via the IP address of the receiver. This removes the single point of failure and fully exploits all possibilities of an IP mesh. Unfortunately, it is uncomfortable and only works in small and stable networks where the IP addresses do not change. As usual, I want it all. Direct calling and the comfort of a PBX. Not easy. Fortunately, my friend Patrick is a voice over IP crack. He had the idea to use these telephones' remote phone books to store all subscribers' IP addresses. He even programmed a prototype. Cool! With these ingredients, my menu was defined. It looks like that. Each participating phone gets a unique phone number. The network maps the numbers to the actual IP address. A telephone book keeps all names and telephone numbers connected to the network. Because this telephone book would be a single point of failure, it has to be distributed to all routers in the network. This has to be done automatically as long as a connection exists. These phone books stay operational even if the link to the phone book server is down. Only changes to the phone book are delayed in this situation. If a phone connects to a router, it automatically gets the latest version of the phone book. If we want to call someone, we search the phone book by name or number and start the call. Because the phone on the other side knows our number, it displays the caller's full name and number. How cool is that? everything has to run on our standard MikroTik routers. If a router is down, the connected telephones anyway are down. No additional single point of failure. And because these routers are pretty standard, we can connect two for redundancy. The delay is also reduced to the minimum because the mesh always chooses the best route. But the whole system broke down during our first test in the field. Extremely frustrating, mainly because we had no idea why it happened. After long hours with Serge, HB9 EDI, we discovered that our Yealink phones did not behave as expected when not registered by a PBX. Because we knew that we did not want a PBX, we had to find a workaround. For the moment, we install Cproxy on each router, so the phones can register. Cproxy is not the right solution, but it is part of standard OpenWRT. I prefer Cipserver, but because it is not compiled for MikroTik routers, I still search for somebody with these skills. Registered, the phones behave as they should and transfer their phone numbers to their recipient. Maybe this is not needed for other brands, we will see. The second problem was a program for the routers that does all the heavy lifting. Because it has to be very small, I decided to use the built-in bash shell and write a script. These routers offer ash and not bash, by the way. It is similar, but has less functionality. I had no clue how to write bash scripts. I only had the requirements in my head. Here you see the requirements in detail. Do you know why I showed you these precise requirements?
Yes, you are right, because I had no clue about coding in bash. ChatGPT became my best friend.
But only if we follow two rules.
First, do not try to prove how stupid ChatGPT is.
Use it as your friend and mentor. Ask again if you get error messages during the execution of your program or if something doesn't work as expected. And number two, you are more intelligent. So write better specifications or ask better questions. That is your job. And discover how difficult it is to precisely write down what you want. With these two rules in mind, I got a decent script that does what I wanted. Of course, I was not able to specify everything in the beginning. The above requirements started small and became longer over time. Fortunately, scope creep is less expensive with these new tools. And you do not have to apologize to the developer for forgotten specifications. I do not show you the results I got from ChatGPT in detail. They are anyway different each time. Try it yourself and judge. And try Google Bard or Microsoft's Bing Chat. Then you learn the differences. That ChatGPT remembers the previous conversation. The others do not, for example. I can say, I became a big fan and I started to learn when it is better to use ChatGPT and when Google. Everything is on GitHub now, but what do you have to do to get this project working? First, you must find somebody to host the files on a server in your AREDN network. I will create another video about this topic because it only interests a few administrators. Then you have to type this command to get an initial settings file and the XML files in your www directory. Do not forget to adjust the web service address before you enter the command line. From now on, the same command is called daily by Crontab. Next, you have to install Cproxy. This is done with this command. Cproxy should automatically start after reboot. Remember that this step is unnecessary if your phone registers to a PBX on your network. The third task is to prepare the phone. Here we have to create an account like that. It registers with Cproxy on your router. People using a PBX already have such an account. We usually give the phone its number as a hostname. This is not needed. However, what is required is to fill out these two screens. It enables the download of your phone book from the router to your phone. After saving, you should see two symbols on your phone's display, and you can select direct or via PBX. Via PBX, of course, only if you selected this option in your settings file. The settings file, by the way, is not replaced by the script. The last step is to publish your phone's address to the mesh. This is done in the setup screen of the router. If your phone is connected, just hit Add and check if its name is correct. It has to be its phone number. Now all other nodes in the mesh will be informed that your phone is waiting for calls. You can search for a contact in your phone book and call them for a test. As long as this phone is registered, you should get an answer. Without a PBX and without a single point of failure. And as a goodie, usually in high definition quality, because you do not create any performance bottlenecks in the network. A small reminder, after every upgrade of the router firmware, you must perform the two steps on the router because our files are deleted during the upgrade. Nothing is needed for the phone. That is all for today. Feel free to contact me if you know somebody able to help with the cross-compilation of SIP server. And if you want to adjust the documentation or scripts for phones of other manufacturers, we can store them on GitHub too. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. 73 to everybody. Please consider supporting the channel using the links in the description. See you in the next episode.